Hi everyone, this is David, and this is a video request. Somebody asked me, they commented, said awesome video request, how to produce videos the way you do. So basically this is just an answer video, and this was a video commented or a comment for the video, how much YouTube paid me in 2020. Now, basically my channel is a tutorial based channel. I do videos basically left, right and center. Something I may have a problem with, something I think people are searching for, something I feel that may be of benefit to the audience or the subscribers to my YouTube channel. So basically everything in between. And the reason why I do this is obviously to inform people and educate people. Now, I record my tutorial videos for YouTube using Camtasia 2020. And for all the other tutorials I've done before Camtasia 2020 was released, was still using Camtasia because I've used it for years now, close to over 11 or 12 years, and I know it inside out. So and basically it's way better. I know some of the few configurations that I can do that are not available on free applications. Now, what's my process? For example, there's this particular video, how to fix the left and right channel recording only issue with Focusrite Scarlett interfaces. Now, that's a problem that people are having with that particular interface, because once you connect it, it only recognizes one side, that is the left side, when you record your audio. So how do you fix it? Simple, just installing the drivers for the particular application and changing the settings in the audio settings. So that's a problem, and then you offer a solution. So that's how I do it. Now, it all starts off with either a problem, an idea, a keyword research. That's the whole process of any content, whether be it a blog or a video. So that's out of the way. Now I use Camtasia Recorder. That is to record my tutorials, and I'll just pull it up. Here's Camtasia Recorder, and it's the whole suite, Camtasia 2020. That is the editor, and the recorder is built in into the editor or into Camtasia. So basically, this is how it looks like. Now, let me just bring this down. And what you just seen here, this is OBS. OBS is what I'm using to record this particular tutorial, because let's just minimize this, because I cannot record Camtasia recording this particular video from the start as I want to. So let me just bring this down, and maybe I'll do a tutorial on how to record your screen using OBS recorder. So just pull this down and then bring it up. This is the Camtasia Recorder 2020, and this is how it looks like. There are a bunch of options here. You might not need to use any of this here, but the recording area is important. If you want to record the whole screen of your computer, then that is important. If you want to adjust, for example, it's recording the whole screen and I want to adjust the particular section that it is recording. Let's say this, let's just remove the padlock so that it doesn't resize this side and this side. So let's say we don't want to show people when this was recorded, because there are people that would look at the date when the tutorial was recorded. Let's say you don't want that. You just want these custom dimensions. That's good. You can work with that. But I always prefer to just have the full screen recorded, so you can just change that from the drop down here. So these are things you can change from these particular sections. And all that, you can also select an area to record. Next up is your camera. You can either select your webcam, or if you have additional webcams available, or even if you have, let's say, a DSLR camera, you can do that. And also a bunch of options. So if I click on the HP wide, my camera goes on. There we go. So basically, we can just turn that off. I don't want it. Because the lighting is not that good in the place that I'm recording. And then we have our mic. We have the area and webcam. This is the inbuilt for the computer. That is the microphone array. And this is for my Focusrite USB audio. Now I'm recording this tutorial using an Audio Technica AT2020. And it's going through the Focusrite Scarlett Solo, second gen, and then into my computer, which is a HP Omen 15. So Basically, that's almost like my recording setup: my laptop, the interface, the mic, and I also have Audio Technica headphones to monitor this particular recording. So that's it. That's for the mic, and you can see the levels. You can adjust these to your liking, but I always like them the recording when it's up to here. And then you have the option to have the speaker or the system audio. That is any sound that is made by the computer, on or off. I always prefer to have it on to avoid, let's say, something being missed that you might have wanted in the particular tutorial, or maybe if you're recording a screen and you needed the audio available. Now, once I'm satisfied with my settings, I've already done my keyword research of the topic I'm going to do. I'm already ready mentally and all that. So all I need to do is just click on record. And let's say for this particular tutorial, I'll do, let's say, a tutorial on how to find a font from, let's say, an image. So potentially this is just a screenshot that I've done previously or before I started this tutorial. I am an ass. To save time, let's just assume that I'm never wrong. So let's just pull up, let's say we start off the recording. It's going to give us a countdown. Hi everyone, my name is David and it's good to have you here. In today's video, I'll show you how to find a font from a logo, a t-shirt, or any picture that you have. Welcome to this video, and if you get any value from this video tutorial, kindly consider subscribing, like the video, and share it with your friends. So that's the intro. Then we go into the meat of things. Let's say in this video, we're going to be using myfonts.com to find a font from a t-shirt or a screenshot of a t-shirt I did. Let's say it's in a supermarket or something of the sort. So I'll just click on upload, and please note that the images supported are PNG or JPG only, and you can also drag an image in here. So let's just click on upload. Let's go to the NAS picture. Here we go. NAS, it should be down here. NAS. Just click on open. And once you click on open, it's going to start analyzing the particular font. Now, you have the option to crop in this particular section, delete, or anything that you need to do. Let's say we just want to crop into the NAS, and then let's just crop in so that we can try and get a font that is as close to this particular font as possible. Now, once you're satisfied with your selection, just click here to identify the selected font. Now, it's going to start identifying the font. And basically, when you look at all the fonts, you already see that this looks like almost a font. Before you actually decide on the font, or the font is this particular font, just make sure you check out some of the fonts that are available, because they are all different typefaces, but you need to make sure you get the font that you want. Also, you can always check for a cheaper font. Some fonts are quite expensive, and if you're going to be using the font only once, you may need to just check out a font that is cheaper. Let's say for the purposes of the video or the particular design that you are doing. So there we go. All fonts seem to be paid here, but you can always check for the simplest or the cheapest font that you do. So that's it for this tutorial on how to find a font from a t-shirt design. So basically, that's the end of the tutorial. So once you're done, you just come either press the F10 key or just pull up this particular interface, Camtasia Recorder interface, and click on stop. And once you click on stop, let's say find a font, you just title your recording so that you know the name of the recording and click on save. Once you click on save, Camtasia by default will pull up this particular recording as a project. Now, it is an untitled project, but it prompts you to start editing once you're done recording. And basically, since this video was on how I record my tutorial videos, I'll do another video on how I edit my tutorial videos from start to finish, because everything is a process. For example, let's say I need to take something out. Let's say I do not want people to see or hear any mistakes from the tutorial. Then I'll do that. Let's say, I think this somewhere I recorded, I indicated the application I'm using. Let's say OBS, somewhere here. Here we go. So basically, that's how you need to edit to take out the fluff. You need to zoom in, you need to do all those kinds of things. So basically, that is how I record tutorial videos using Camtasia 2020 for my YouTube channel and everything in between. And for the purposes of this video, I used OBS, which is a free screen recorder and streaming application that you can also use. The only limitation is that you'll need a video editor to maybe zoom in on the sections that you want to zoom in. And then if you wanted to do, let's say something like blur out maybe emails, you may need an application like Camtasia. And that's why I always prefer to just go straight on with Camtasia without the need to use any other application. But OBS is a good application. You can use it. And I've used it for some tutorials that need me to record my Camtasia interface. So that's it for this video tutorial. I hope that is going to be beneficial to you to know how to record tutorials for YouTube or even for any other application that you might have. So in the next video, I'll show you how I edit my Camtasia recordings inside Camtasia. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thank you for watching.